Hey everyone, Rodney here at Cleves Tech, and today I'm going to show you how to get accurate text on t-shirts on people in your images like these. Now this is not something that works perfectly, but it does often do a pretty decent job, but it depends on the image that you're working with, and I'm going to make things difficult on myself, and I'm not going to use easy images to do this, so we're going to try to generate some stuff like this. I do recommend watching my video I have on text already that this is building upon. This is a little more difficult than that. That works very well. This one's a challenge sometimes, but I'm going to give you the tips on how you can try to get better results from it. So why don't we just start and get right into it. So t-shirts and putting designs on them. There's no perfect way of doing this, and this doesn't always work well with every image generated. So I'm going to show you the system of how I do it. Hopefully these come out well. Gotten some to come out well, and others it can be a challenge. The idea behind this is trying to generate images, t-shirts with words on them and sayings, or designs with words and getting accurate text. This is purely about text, but also can be used for other stuff as well. Because one of the issues is a lot of times if you try to get what you want, obviously it's not going to work. If you use inpainting, it looks copied and pasted. Now, there are other ways of doing this sort of stuff. Like for example, in this one, I did in GIMP. Which I can show at the end of this video real quick how I did this. This is useful doing it that way if you have a specific design you're trying to get on there. It doesn't always work perfectly, but it is an option. Let's say you want to go ahead and generate one and you want to have the text and stuff like that to actually work and spell the proper words. Well, that's what I'm going to show you today. So for this one, let's go ahead and just start off with one of these images. But first, I'm going to set everything up. I'm using Fooocus. You should be able to do this in pretty much any of the UIs. There's a little bit different on how they work. I do like the inpaint engine for Fooocus, and I personally think it's the best, even if you just use it for inpainting. So we're going to put check off the input image tab down at the bottom. We're going to be mostly working in the inpaint, outpaint, and the image prompt area. Down here, I'm going to check off advanced as well. In the advanced tab, we're going to check off the developer debug mode. And in here, we're going to go into the control tab. We need mixing image prompt and inpaint. We're going to check that off. Then we're just going to click on the inpaint tab and have that open. A lot of times, if you were just to go ahead and do this and then try to use the image prompts with the text that I'm going to show, it's not going to work properly. Things won't line up. But I'll show you how to get that to work. If you have seen my other video on how to get good text, this is basically the same idea with some slight modifications. Basic concept is still the same. And if you haven't seen that, I do suggest looking at that. And that one, it works well on like flat surfaces for signs or anything like that. The shirts were a little harder. As I said, it doesn't always work for every shirt. Doesn't always work for every design. It takes a little bit of practice, but once you get used to it, you can get halfway decent results. They may not always look perfect though. I will warn you of that. And if you see any flickering or anything while I'm doing this, my video card I think is about to die, so hopefully not. I'd like to be able to continue recording videos and not have to put that on pause. So let's start off with, we'll go with this image down here. Yeah, we'll do this one. Drag it down. Then in the inpainting area, I'm gonna select a larger mask. And if you're not familiar with inpainting, I do suggest watching my inpainting tutorial. Now, what we need to do at this point is we're not going to generate anything. It doesn't really matter. We can get rid of some of these things in the prompt. Want to put your text in the quotes. Now, we're going to be using something different for this, but we are going to just prepare the prompt at the moment. The inpaint respective field. That's what we want to pay attention to first right here. Now, if we go all the way to one, when it goes to inpaint, it's going to use the whole image. It won't upscale, won't do anything. But what happens is at that point, we're going to be putting some text into the image prompt. And when we do that, it's going to have a hard time keeping that text together because it's going to be so small at that point. So we need to have the image zoom in. And the way to do that is to slide this down. Now, normally it's around 6 or so, but we actually are going to slide this not all the way down because then it doesn't take any of the image around it into effect, and we want that because it's useful for reference. So I'm going to bring this down a little bit, probably to about 0.2. We'll give that a shot. Now the first time we generate, we're actually not going to generate anything. I just need to get some numbers. And if you've watched my other video on text, you'll know why I'm doing this. But at this point, once we go ahead and hit the generate button, we're going to want the command window open. Now My system, when I go to do this in upscale while I'm recording, can have issues. So I'm going to try to leave this open to show you exactly what happens. So let's hit generate. Now I'll minimize my window here and we'll see if it actually does this. But so there's one number you want to pay attention to here. That's the 425 by 425. That's the section of the image that it's going to be working on. Now, the other thing I do here as well is for reference, I'm going to take a screenshot of this. And that's just so I have a rough idea of what it's working on. So I'm going to save that. Now that we have that, we can work on getting our text. We don't need this to finish, but I'm going to let this finish because I do want to show something. One of the things to keep in mind when doing this. So we're going to hit stop. So a lot of the problems that comes up is in here, the shirt doesn't look right. We're wanting to get more of a faded look, worn look. So that's where this doesn't always work well when you try to do the inpainting on the shirt. And I'm going to show you, that's the point I'm going to show you here is how to get around that. Now we want to get our text. So I've already got one prepared here, but I'm going to change the size because I don't have the proper size because I didn't know. So we're going to put 425. I'm going to resize this. The other thing to do that I do is I'll bring in that image. And that's close enough for what we're doing here. I got my text where I want it. And you can use any tool. I do this in Adobe Express just because I like the way that the text effects, how they can, you know, the text, working with text in here works very well. The other thing to keep in mind is when you're working with the text, the font, it's usually best to have a thicker, bolder font, and it won't always keep the same font. Yeah, we'll go with this one. We're gonna leave it there. And the background color, I find, I don't know, it, you don't wanna go with transparent, that doesn't work well. I'm still trying to figure out if which colors work the best, but I tend to go with the same background color. And then we're going to go ahead and download and save that image. We're going to go to our image prompt tab, and then I'm going to bring in that text that I just created. I'm going to put this on CPDS. PyraCanny can work as well. Play around, determine, you know, the stop at is when it stops influencing it. You are going to want that usually pretty high. Otherwise, the text can start to fall apart. But the higher you go also, it does impact the rest of the generation. So now the other thing is, if you want to do anything else, like I'm going to drop this image in here just as a reference. So for the robot, there we go. Now I have everything set. I have my prompt set. I do have the text in the prompt and here. So that helps influence each other. If you don't put the text in the prompt, I find it doesn't work as well. Now, we're not going to touch this inpaint respective field at this point because we've already set this. And if we were to change that, it's going to mess up the image prompt that we're using. The other thing we need to do is the inpaint denoising strength. One of the reasons that this looks kind of fake is because it regenerates that whole image right from scratch, where we've masked. So if we go in and look here, that gets completely regenerated. So what we want to do, especially if we want to make the shirt look more like it's worn, like the graphics are on the shirt, and to maintain some of those wrinkles and things like that and contours that make it look more believable, we're going to need to lower this down. That way it doesn't completely destroy what's underneath it. It still uses now a high number means that it mostly starts from scratch. If you bring it way down here, it means that it barely will change anything at all. And actually, we go down there, it's not gonna do anything for the most part. You're gonna need to at least be over 0.5 to get mostly any results, but let's start around 1.75. And this really depends on the look you're going for. And each image is gonna be slightly different. So you're gonna have to play with that as you start generating it. And let's go ahead and generate this and see what we start getting for results now. Okay, so let's look at our images we have here. And these actually came out pretty decent. You can see the letters do kind of follow some of the, now some of these aren't gonna come out perfect. So we get a pretty good job. I'm gonna lower this down a little bit more. I'm going to put that down closer to 7. Okay, let's see if we can change this up a little bit and get it a little more faded. A couple of these actually, this one actually I thought came out pretty good. And at this point, let's say we wanted that, but we didn't like the design, we could inpaint just that area of it. But once you get the text right, you can always work around it. We'll go ahead and try another shot. It just came out halfway decent. Now, you can adjust the CPDS and other things to get better text. You can also just have it zoom in more if you want to maintain that structure, especially if you have smaller text. If you want to really go in, you can zoom in even more. Similar to how I show in my other video on how to do text. But the biggest thing in here is going to be this denoising strength is the big difference. Because in order to keep the shape better so it looks more realistic, you do need to turn that down. But if you turn it down too much, then it's also getting more difficult. The other thing to keep in mind I didn't show here, but this will work for more than just text. You could include images in here to help guide it. You can include, you know, logos, whatever you want. That's entirely up to you how you can do it, but this just gives you the basic idea of how to get that. And obviously, once you get the basic design, you can then go from there and inpaint it. Now, I will mention the one thing you might want to do is if you're going to be upscaling your images, you can upscale them first and then do this because you'll be working with a smaller area when you do the inpainting and that respective field. So you can actually do that with an upscaled image as well. Okay, so I've decided let's go ahead and do an upscaled image. So I've gone ahead, I got this image here I generated here. It's gonna be a little bit tougher because it's further back. So that would be normally very difficult if you tried doing it under the normal image prompts without adjusting things because your text would be so small that it wouldn't maintain the structure. But we shouldn't have that issue because we're into the same technique. So let's go ahead and I've gone ahead and already masked the area. Get that out of the way. In the image prompt, I've changed things a little bit now. So I put the robot everything right on that image. That way I can get more. I'm going to increase the weight a little bit to stop at. I have this in the image prompt just for the style, the look and everything to help influence that result. The prompt all set. I've got the inpaint denoising strength set. Let's go a little bit lower on that. Yeah, there we go. And I've measured everything out. So this hopefully should work. And like I said, this has been upscaled. So this is already an upscaled image. Don't worry if the eyes are weird. I didn't work on any of that yet. I usually do that after the fact. So let's go ahead and do this. So looking at these four, I'd say, I mean, overall, they're not too bad. Well, this one didn't get the text right. But this is a perfect example. Let's say you did like this, but just that text part at the bottom. Then you could just start and just do that section. Just mask that area, remeasure, and figure it out from there and just continue. Yeah, this one didn't come out that good. Yeah, this one's not too bad. But now I actually, you know, I like this one the most. And what I would normally do at this point is I can go ahead and regenerate just the areas that I don't like. Okay, so that was one of the other ones. I got the order wrong. Anyways, so that one and the other one are two I thought did well. This one, I go ahead and I would mask this area to remove if I don't want this text. This one, I am perfectly fine with that text. We'll clear this out. I'm gonna get rid of these things now because let's say I just want to finish touching those things up. I will go ahead and change that. I'm going to change the denoising strength now because what I'm going to do here. And we're going to get rid of all that because I don't want that to influence generation. Put that in there. See, I think we're good to go. Let's give this a shot. So we got a couple images. I'm not sure which one. Well, this one's fine. Now we have our images and I'll give you a couple bonuses now. So this should give you a good idea of how to get to this point. Now I didn't do many image generations. I didn't really push it. I just wanted to show the technique. this gets a lot easier if you're not trying to do it on like the images I'm trying to do. Is the dirty, they're worn out, all that sort of stuff. If you're putting it on somebody that's got a more smoother shirt, things like that, not the wrinkles, it does get easier to get a better result. But I wanted to kind of show the more difficult situations. Now, if you really want to take that to the next level and make it look really phenomenal, this will be using Magnific AI. I'll show you real quick. This does cost a bit of money. Unless you do a lot of upscaling and you want a lot of detail, I don't necessarily recommend this, but if you're using it enough, it is worth it. The first one I'm gonna do is the one I just did. I'm gonna put my prompt in here. Let's go with a scaling factor of 2. I'm gonna keep the resemblance up. We're gonna leave everything else fine. Yeah, let's go with that. I'm gonna go up ahead and upscale that. Now, if you were wondering, as I mentioned before about getting a design on a shirt in GIMP, I can kind of show you how to do that. Let's see if I can remember what I had to do this. Okay, open as layer. Da, da, da. Okay. Let's see, we'll scale this down. I'm not going to go for perfection here. At this point, you could, if you needed to, rotate it or anything like that. I'm not going to worry about that right now. And then I'm just going to change this. If we go down to the mode on that layer, and you can try different ones, but usually I find overlay works pretty good. And there we go. Now, this shirt, it doesn't look perfect. And you can, at this point, lower the opacity as well. That'll have it, help it blend in. There's a lot of little tweaks you can do, but that's pretty much how you would do it in GIMP. There's, like I said, you could change. There's other ones. Soft light will do it as well. Play around with different ones, and you can sometimes, it depends on the image. So that's how you can do something like that in GIMP if you want to. So let's check our Magnific upscale. Okay, here we go. Now, went a little extreme, but that one actually came out really good. There we go. I will say, I really love Magnific. Just wish it wasn't so expensive. So if you really want to up your game, that's the way to do it. Well, that covers everything for this video. And as I said, it does take a little tweaking and practice. May not always work with every image, but it is one of the better ways that I've found. If someone's got a better way, I'd love to hear it in the comments. I'm always looking for improvements and better ways of doing things. And this is not limited to t-shirts and can be used for other things as well. If you found this video helpful, please hit the like button so others may discover it as well. Thank you to everyone that has donated to help the channel, and thanks for watching. Now have fun creating.